Welcome to Health Bulletin. In recent weeks, alarming reports have surfaced of the first cases of fatal BC deer zombie. These shocking incidents are sending shockwaves through the community as authorities scramble to understand and contain the mysterious disease. Researchers say a deadly disease starts out slow, but has the potential to devastate British Columbia's deer population over time after the discovery of the first cases in the province. The concerns come after the BC government confirmed two cases of chronic wasting disease found in animals south of Cranbrook region. The cases were found in a mule deer harvested by a hunter and another in a white-tailed deer that was hit by a vehicle on the road. As the number of infected deer continues to rise, concerns grow about the potential impact on other animals and even human health. Canadian Food Inspection Agency lab confirmed the chronic wasting disease diagnosis on Wednesday. So far, the disease has the potential to decimate deer populations, as infected animals are initially hard to identify, and generally they don't survive more than 2 years once infected. Some experimental data shows the disease also has the theoretical potential to infect other species, such as humans, but there have been no known cases of spillover beyond the deer family, which also includes elk, caribou, and moose. The major concern in the room is always whether the disease could spill over into humans. We have not seen a case leading to disease in humans so far, but it's one of those things that we have experimental data that says it could happen. Presently, there is no direct evidence of chronic wasting disease being transmitted to humans. Meanwhile, Health Canada and the World Health Organization advised people should not eat infected animals. The question, how to identify if an animal is infected or not? Health official has issued an advisory if anyone who sees a deer, elk, moose, or caribou exhibiting symptoms, such as poor coordination, stumbling, maybe weight loss, or general sickness for no obvious reason, should report the sighting to the BC Wildlife Health Program immediately. However, the disease is spread from region to region through the transport of carcasses or contaminated hay. Remember, CWD, the disease affects an animal's central nervous system and causes cell death in the brain, with a fatality rate of 100%, and currently no known treatment is available. Previously, the disease has been in Alberta for decades, and can now be found in at least 5 provinces, as well as more than 30 states' southern border. Experts believe the spread of the disease into BC to the neighboring borders with Alberta and Montana is likely possible, and chance of more cases will pop up. It's typical for the disease to start slow, just like it is in BC. But in southern region Saskatchewan, now where more than 80% of the mule deer bucks are positive for the disease, which is alarming. So this is ultimately going to have a huge impact on the deer population. Many wildlife conservists more disappointing because of less efforts given to fight the spread. This is a slow-moving, insidious disease, and it takes quite a long time to build up in a population. Expert believes initially we don't see any effects whatsoever, but within in 1 or 2 or 3 decades, there will be drastic changes in the deer populations. As of now, officials trying to control the spread by culling populations with positive cases, there is considerable ongoing research to try to provide better tools to control the disease. The alarming rise of fatal BC deer zombie cases is a warning sign that cannot be ignored. Thanks for watching, and if you enjoyed this video, make sure to subscribe to our channel for more valuable content. Stay healthy and see you next time.